to make a sepal, or the little green thing that goes at the end, I'm going to do the exact same thing. Only this time I'm using the very small, the smallest of the cutters. And again, I'm going to cut this very tightly because I don't want it to be very big. This clay is quite soft. It's got a lot of the translucent in it. Again, take the peach pick and gently shape if you need to inside the cuts. I'm going to use the small shaper this time and cup the ends, cup the center like I did before, and begin to shape it around the point. And now I'm going to turn it around and again begin to shape this, but not so much as before because I want it to slide over the end of this cap. So I'm going to get a nice big area. Now here's what's really cool. You can take your peach pick and roll the point down like this. And as you roll it down, it becomes thinner and thinner and loses the rounded shape. Just gently roll, not too hard. Now I'm going to hold it and twist the tool out and take my fingers and just pinch those little tiny points just a bit. It's too tight to fit now, so I'm going to open it up slightly, like this. Put the point of the trumpet flower into the cupped shape and gently pinch it onto the piece. And notice how I'm holding the flower on the tool rather than my fingers. As I pinch, again, I'm not pushing, I'm just pinching. And now you can take the tiny peach pick and lay it down and roll like this, and you will create the separations in the sepals. Again, a gentle twist and remove. Now you have a trumpet flower with sepals. You could do one of two things with it. I like to do this. I like to make a hole through using the peach pick, and I'm feeling it with my finger going directly through all of this. And then these can be baked on a bead wire, and after they're baked and strung, you could have earrings or charms for bracelets. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.